Corum Jhaelen Irsei is the name of a fictional fantasy hero in a series of novels written by Michael Moorcock. The character was introduced in the novel The Knight of Swords, published in 1971. This was followed by two other books published during the same year, The Queen of Swords and The King of Swords. The three novels are collectively known as the Corum Chronicles trilogy or the Chronicles of Corum. Both The Knight of the Swords and The King of the Swords won the August Derleth Award in 1972 and 1973 respectively. The character then starred in three books making up the Silver Hand trilogy, and has appeared in other stories taking place in Moorcock's multiverse. Corum is a hero with disabilities, losing his left hand and right eye early in his first story. The hand and eye are later replaced by the Eye of Rin and the Six-Fingered Hand of KWLL, powerful artifacts that help Corum against his enemies. Corum is usually reluctant to use these two artifacts, as they involve methods and dark forces that conflict with his personal morality. Since the Eye of Rin causes Corum to see multiple planes of reality simultaneously, he often wears an eye patch over it to keep from being overwhelmed. After he loses both artifacts, Corum relies on a normal eye patch and a silver prosthetic hand. Corum is one of many incarnations of Michael Moorcock's Eternal Champion, a soul who is reborn frequently throughout the multiverse and usually fights to restore or maintain the cosmic balance between chaos and law. In some stories, Corum's adventures allow him to meet other aspects of the Eternal Champion, such as Elric of Melniboné, Urikos, and Dorian Hawkmoon. While Elric famously owes allegiance to the chaos god Arioch, Corum follows the cause of law and begins his adventures by opposing the plans of Arioch. Corum lives during an age before recorded history, when human beings are rising on Earth and beginning to war with the planet's older societies. Corum's race, the Vada, understands advanced science regarding the nature of reality. Through force of will, they are able to perceive and even shift through different dimensional planes for different purposes. The primitive humans of the age mistake these scientific tricks for sorcery and believe the Vada engage in demonic rituals and witchcraft. Corum's people are long-lived and believe they have nothing to fear from humans. Over the centuries, they become complacent and ignorant of the world around them. As a result, they are taken by surprise when a human tribe hunts them down and slaughters them. The last survivor, as far as he knows, Corum is tortured and mutilated by the human barbarians, losing an eye and a hand before he escapes. He wants vengeance against all humanity, but later learns humans make up many societies of different beliefs and moralities. After encountering sorcerers and godlike beings, Corum learns all reality is influenced by the forces of chaos and law. Corum dedicates himself to maintaining balance between both forces, as disaster and death occur if either side holds too much influence. This trilogy consists of the Knight of the Swords, the Queen of the Swords, and the King of the Swords. In the United Kingdom, it has been collected as an omnibus edition titled Corum, Swords of Corum, and most recently Corum, the Prince in the Scarlet Robe. In the United States, the first trilogy has been published as Corum, The Coming of Chaos. Plot: Corum is a Vada, one of a race of long-lived beings with limited magical abilities dedicated to peaceful pursuits such as art and poetry. A group of Mabdan led by the savage Earl Glandith Acray raid the family castle and slaughter everyone with the exception of Corum, who escapes. Arming himself, Corum attacks and kills several of the Mabdan before being captured and tortured. After having his left hand cut off and right eye put out, Corum escapes by moving into another plane of existence, becoming invisible to the Mabdan. They depart and Corum is found by the Brown Man, a dweller of the Forest of Lar, able to see Corum while out of phase. The Brown Man takes Corum to a being called Arkin, who treats his wounds and explains he has a higher purpose. Traveling to Moidal's castle, Corum encounters his future lover, the Margravine Ralina, a Mabdan woman of the civilized land of Limanesh. Having found out Corum's location by torturing and killing the Brown Man of Lar, Glandith Acray marshaled his allies to Moidal's castle. Glandith had kept Corum's former hand and eye as souvenirs, and showed them to Corum to provoke a reaction. Ralina uses sorcery to ward off an attack by Glandith Acray. Determined to restore himself, Corum and Ralina travel to the island of Shul, a near-immortal and mad sorcerer. During the journey, Corum observes a mysterious giant who trawls the ocean with a net. On arrival at the island, Shul takes Ralina hostage, and then provides Corum with two artifacts to replace his lost hand and eye, the Hand of KWLL and the Eye of Rin. The Eye of Rin allows Corum to see into an undead netherworld where the last beings killed by Corum exist until summoned by the Hand of KWLL. Shul then explains that Corum's ill fortune has been caused by the Chaos God Arioch, the Knight of the Swords. when Ariok and his fellow Chaos Lords conquered the 15 planes, the balance between the forces of law and chaos tipped in favor of chaos, and their minions, such as Glandiffe Cray, embarked on a bloody rampage. Shul sends Corum to Ariok's fortress to steal the heart of Ariok, which the sorcerer intends to use to attain greater power. Corum confronts Ariok, and learns Shul is nothing more than a pawn of the Chaos God. Ariok then ignores Corum, who discovers the location of the heart. Corum is then attacked by Ariok, but the hand of KWLL crushes the heart and banishes the Chaos God forever. Before fading from existence, Ariok warns Corum that he has now earned the enmity of the Sword Rulers. Corum returns to the island to rescue Relina, and observes Shul has become a powerless moron, and is devoured by his own creation soon afterwards. Corum learns Arkin is in fact a Lord of Law, and that this is the first step towards Law regaining control of the 15 planes. On another 5 planes, the forces of Chaos, led by Shambarg, Queen of the Swords, reign supreme and are on the verge on eradicating the last resistance from the forces of Law. The avatars of the Bear and Dog Gods plot with Earl Glandiffe Cray to murder Corum and return Ariok to the 15 planes. Guided by Arkin, Corum, Ralina and companion Jiria Kono cross the plains and encounter the king without a country, the last of his people who in turn is seeking the city in the pyramid. The group locate the city, which is in fact a floating arsenal powered by advanced technology and inhabited by a people originally from Corum's world and his distant kin. Besieged by the forces of Chaos, the city requires certain rare minerals to continue to power their weapons. Corum and Jiri attempt to locate the minerals and also encounter Shambarg, who learns of Corum's identity. Corum slows Shambarg's forces by defeating their leader, Prince Gainer the Damned. Shambarg is goaded into attacking the city directly in revenge for Ariok's banishment. Arkin provides the minerals and confronts Shambarg, who has manifested in a vulnerable state. As Arkin banishes Shambarg, Corum and his allies devastate the forces of Chaos. Glandiffe Cray, however, escapes and seeks revenge. A spell, determined to have been cast by the forces of Chaos, forces the inhabitants of Corum's plain to war with each other. Desperate to stop the slaughter, Corum, Ralina and Jiria Konal travel to the last 5 planes, ruled by Mabelode, the King of the Swords. Ralina is taken hostage by the forces of Chaos and Corum has several encounters with the forces of Chaos, including Earl Glandiffe Cray. Corum also meets two other aspects of the Eternal Champion, Elric and Arikos, with all three seeking the mystical city of Tainlorn for their own purposes. After a brief adventure in the Vanishing Tower, the other heroes depart and Corum and Jiri arrive at their version of Tainlorn. Corum discovers one of the lost gods, the being KWLL, who is imprisoned and cannot be freed until whole. Corum offers KWLL his hand, on the condition that he aid them against Mabelode. KWLL accepts the terms, but reneges on the bargain until persuaded to assist. Corum is also stripped of his artificial eye, which belongs to Rin, actually the mysterious giant Corum had previously encountered. KWLL transports Corum and Anjuri to the court of Mabelode, with the pair fleeing with Ralina when KWLL directly challenges the Chaos God. In a final battle, Corum avenged his family by killing Glandiffe Cray and decimating the last of Chaos' mortal forces. KWLL later located Corum and revealed that all the gods, of both Chaos and Law, have been slain in order to free humanity and allow it to shape its own destiny. This trilogy consists of the Bull and the Spear, the Oak and the Ram, and the Sword and the Stallion. It was titled The Prince with the Silver Hand in the United Kingdom and The Chronicles of Corum in the United States respectively. The previous trilogy hinted at a Celtic or Proto-Celtic setting for the stories. The terms Mabvin and Sheffinhow occurring in these books are both Cornish language words. The Silver Hand trilogy is more explicit in its Celtic connections, with overt borrowings from Celtic mythology. Plot set 80 years after the defeat of the Sword Rulers, Corum has become despondent and alone since the death of his Mabvin bride Ralina. Plagued by voices at night, Corum believes he has gone insane until old friend Jiria Konal advises Corum it is in fact a summons from another world. Listening to the voices allows Corum to pass to the other world, which is in fact the distant future. The descendants of Ralina's folk, the Tuana Krem Croic, who call Corum Corum Lu Irint, face extinction by the Foy Maior. The Foy Maior, 7 powerful but diseased and barely sentient giants, with the aid of their allies have conquered the land and plunged it into eternal winter. Aligning himself with King Manich, ruler of the Tuana Krem Croic, Corum falls in love with his daughter Medv. Corum also hears the prophecy of a seeress, who claims Corum should fear a brother, a harp and above all, beauty. Corum seeks the lost artifacts of the Tuatha Crem Croic, a sacred bull, a spear, an oak, a ram, a sword and a stallion, which will restore the land. Corum gains new allies, Goffinan and Goffinan's cousin and true giant Hilbrek. They battle the Foy Maior, who themselves have allies, a returned Prince Gainer, the wizard Kalatin and his clone of Corum, the Brothers of the Pine, the undead ghoul and a host of giant demonic dogs. After being instrumental in the death of two of the Foy Maior and restoring to his senses the encircled Aurine, the High King and Chief Druid of the Tuatha Crem Croic, Corum and his allies fight a final battle in which all their foes are destroyed. Corum decides not to return his own world, and is attacked by his clone, whom he defeats with the aid of a spell placed on his silver hand by Medv. Medv, however, attacks and wounds Corum, having been told by the being the Dagda that their world must be free of all gods and demigods if they are to flourish as a people. Corum is then killed with his own sword by his animated silver hand, thereby fulfilling the prophecy. The Swords Trilogy, The Silver Hand Trilogy, Additional Appearances, The August Derleth Award won by, First Comics published The Chronicles of Corum, a 12-issue limited series that adapted the Swords Trilogy. And was followed by the 4-issue limited series Corum, The Bull and the Spear 1989, which adapted the first book in the second trilogy. Deicide Productions produced a supplement for use with Chaosium Stormbringer role-playing game adapting the characters and settings from the Corum series for role-playing. Gollancz released the entire Corum stories in both print and ebook form, commencing in 2013. The ebooks are available via Gollancz's SF Gateway site. In 2016, Graphic Audio produced dramatized audiobook versions of Corum. Thanks for watching.